Loops and decisions. Loops. If we want to give a specific command over and over again, we make use of loops. Suppose you want to write a program that displays the tables. If we write the program using only the things that we have learned till now, the program will look like this. \ program to print tables without using loop. Now, if we write the same program using loops, see how the size of the program will reduce. \ program to print tables using loop. Integer a is equal to 2, semicolon. Integer I, semicolon. For open bracket, I is equal to 1, semicolon. I less than or equal to 10, semicolon. I plus plus, close bracket, open curly bracket. C out, open inverted commas, 2 asterisks, close inverted comma. I, open inverted commas, is equal to close inverted commas. A asterisk I, single inverted commas, backslash n, close single inverted commas, semicolon, close curly bracket, get character, open bracket, close bracket, semicolon, close curly bracket. Come on, let us see the different types of loops and how they are used in our program. For loop. The very first loop we will learn about is the for loop, which was used in the example before. A for loop has three sections. Initialization expression. In the for loop given in the example, I is equal to 1 is called the initialization expression. The variable I is called a loop variable. The value of the loop variable at the beginning of the loop is specified here. Test expression. This part always makes use of a relational operator. Till the time that this expression remains true, the commands in the loop will be executed over and over again. In the example given, I is less than or equal to 10 is a test expression. Till the time the value of I is less than or equal to 10, the code in the loop will be executed again and again. Increment expression. In this expression, command as to how the value of the loop variable needs to be changed is given. In the given example, increment expression is I++, which means that each time the loop is executed, the value of I is increased by 1. The way to write this command is as follows. For, open bracket, initialization expression, semicolon, test expression, semicolon, increment expression, close bracket, open curly bracket, \, the code that needs to be executed again and again needs to be \ written here. Close curly bracket. A semicolon should be used to separate the initialization expression from the test expression and also between the test expression and the increment expression. The commands that need to be executed again and again should be written between these symbols. Open curly bracket, close curly bracket. The program with loop and without loop will give the same output. Now suppose you want to show the tables for 2 up to 2 multiplied by 100. In the first program, you would need to add 90 more lines. But in the second program, you would only need to change this line for open bracket, I is equal to 1, semicolon, I less than or equal to 10, semicolon, I plus plus, close bracket, 2, open bracket, I is equal to 1, semicolon, I less than or equal to 100, semicolon, I plus plus, close bracket. So, won't you say that loops are useful? While loop. The commands given in this loop will be executed till the time the relational expression is true. If we want to write the program for the tables using while loop, it will look like this. Integer I is equal to 1, semicolon, while, open bracket, I is less than or equal to 10, close bracket, open curly bracket, C out, open inverted commas, 2 asterisks, close inverted commas, I, open inverted commas is equal to close inverted commas, A asterisk I, single inverted comma, backslash N, close single inverted commas, semicolon, I plus plus, semicolon, close curly bracket. Till the time the value of I is less than or equal to 10, the code in the while loop will be executed. One thing that is important and we need to pay attention to here is that we need to change the value of the loop variable in the loop. If this is not done, then the value of the loop variable will remain constant and the relational expression will always return true. If this happens, the loop will run non-stop. Such a situation is called as infinite loop, and there is no option but to stop the program forcefully in such situations. Do while loop. If the relational expression returns false the very first time it is checked, then the code inside the while loop is never executed. However, sometimes it is necessary that the code should be executed at least once. During such times, the do while loop is used. The program for displaying tables will be modified like this if it is written using the do while loop. Integer I is equal to 1 semicolon, do open curly bracket, C out, open inverted commas, 2 asterisks, close inverted commas, I open inverted commas is equal to close inverted commas, A asterisks I, single inverted comma, backslash n, single inverted comma close, semicolon, I plus plus, semicolon, close curly bracket, while, open bracket, I is less than or equal to 10, close bracket, semicolon. You will observe that in this loop, the relational expression is checked in the end. Nested loops. When one loop is written inside another loop, it is called as nested loop. Suppose you want to display the tables for the numbers from 2 to 5, then the program can be written with two for loops like this. Double slash nested for loops, hashtag include conio.h, hashtag include iostream.h, void main, open bracket, close bracket, open curly bracket, clear screen, open bracket, close bracket, semicolon, integer I, comma j, semicolon, for open bracket I is equal to 2, semicolon, I is less than or equal to 5, semicolon, I plus plus, close bracket, open curly bracket, for open bracket j is equal to 1, semicolon, j less than or equal to 10, semicolon, j plus plus, close bracket, open curly bracket, C out, I, open inverted commas, asterisk, close inverted commas, j, open inverted commas, is equal to, close inverted commas, I asterisk j, open single inverted comma, backslash n, close single inverted comma, semicolon, close curly bracket, get character, open bracket, semicolon, close curly bracket. You will observe that in this program we have written two for loops, one inside the other. The first for loop, for open bracket I is equal to 2, semicolon, I less than or equal to 5, semicolon, I plus plus, close bracket, decides the number for which the table is to be written. Since we want to write the tables from 2 to 5, I is initialized to 2 and the loop runs till the value of I is less than or equal to 5. The next for loop, for open bracket j is equal to 1, semicolon, j is less than or equal to 10, semicolon, j plus plus, close bracket, is written inside this for loop and it does the work of displaying the tables. We want to display the tables for the given number starting at multiplied by 1 and ending at multiplied by 10. Hence, the value of j is initialized to 1 and the loop runs till the value of j is less than or equal to 10. In short, what happens here is when the code enters the first for loop, the value of I is 2. Now the second for loop starts. The value of I remains constant in this loop. Only the value of j changes. So the code cout I open inverted commas asterisk close inverted commas j open inverted commas is equal to close inverted commas I asterisk j single inverted comma open backslash n close single inverted comma semicolon starts displaying from 2 into 1 and ends at 2 into 10. Now the value of I is increased by 1 and it becomes equal to 3 and the table for 3 is shown. This process repeats till all the tables till 5 are displayed. Now the external loop also ends and the get character open bracket close bracket command is executed.